звезды мировой пластической хирургии с Ольгой Засеевой. Эстетика в разрезе. Джуми Масия, профессор, директор отделения микрохирургии и реконструкции молочной железы клиники Планас в Барселоне, один из идеологов мирового движения Breast Meeting.
You are one of the inventors of this very famous, let's say, road you made as a Breast Meeting, and we are very happy to be as Moscow Breast Meeting part of your big concept. So tell me, how did you come up to this idea? Because you were the inventor, you were the first one.
The thing is sometimes you don't need to invent. It's something that appears in a spontaneous way, and you need to be there and you need to help a little bit. No? It's like a natural delivery. You know, it's just go and appear the baby. And I think it was like this. You know, for many years there was under the societies, you know, like the Spanish society, the French society, the German society of plastic surgery or breast surgery. But these kind of societies at the end, they are always, you know, under some politic affairs, you know. It's like sometimes there are people who are not the best, sometimes there are people that are against the other ones. And at the end, the meetings that the congresses, they are not really good, or at least they are not good enough. And they in that places the education is not well orientated, and for that reason is when we decide why we can start doing something completely independent, just trying to invite the best people and to a little bit make what we want to give to the people, you know, kind of education in that field. And then from that idea is when we start to have this kind of meetings where we wanted to talk about breast oncology, breast reconstruction, breast aesthetic, and give a global vision of the breast, because it's the only way to do the right approach nowadays in this kind of surgery.
Звезды мировой пластической хирургии с Ольгой Засеевой. Эстетика в разрезе. Джуми Масия, профессор, директор отделения микрохирургии и реконструкции молочной железы клиники Планас в Барселоне, один из идеологов мирового движения Breast Meeting.
So breast for me is quite a small topic.
You are right. When you see it looks like a small field, but it's not a small field. First, because when you see the balance, for example, in the more medical part, it means that with the pathology, breast cancer is extremely important and is a high prevalence, and it is one of the big problems of all the healthcare systems, because still is rising. Okay, so there are
is
many.
Is number one, or it's?
Is the number one breast cancer? Is the breast cancer is the number one cancer in women, and is the most important. When you see all the cancers for men and women, the most important is breast cancer. Why? Because it's affecting to a very young group of people, the women between 35 and 55. It means productive women, people who are working, women who are taking care of the children, families, and women who are the main pillar of our society. That is probably the most important disease in our society, and in numbers is one every eight women has breast cancer or had at risk to have breast cancer. So we have in one side big problem, and there is a lot of research, new therapies, you know, prophylactic, genetics, radiotherapy, surgery. Is a lot of innovations every year in breast cancer. But also on the other side, in the side of the aesthetic, breast is so important for women, and in fact this is the first. It is the first in number when you see all the aesthetics. First is breast enlargement, second is liposuction, third is breast reduction, and you see breast again is what is the most important for our women in all societies. So I think this field are enough, you know, there is enough importance to be, you know, every year talking. And then you can see what is happening here. We do every year here in Moscow, and it's completely full.
Yes.
That is a good sign that there is a high demand for learning breast surgery, breast oncology, breast reconstruction, breast aesthetic, all kinds.
Эстетика в разрезе.
I know that you very often teach or present in United States. They invite you as a key speaker. What is the difference between European school and American school?
There is a big difference between the medicine in Europe and the medicine in US. When you see from outside, in both sides you have very, you know, relevant people and a lot of research. But when you see the way to approach in Europe, the medicine is more fair, is more honest. For us, in general, even if we are living from medicine, it's not a real business. It's more like, it's something like the concept of the ethics for the doctor is for help people. And then we always try to provide the best, even is not paid. For example, sometimes you do long operations that they are not paid or they are bad paid, but you believe that is the best.
So Europe is more human oriented, yeah?
Yeah, and in United States it's more business. For example, if something is not paid by the companies, they don't do.
Okay.
If something is less paid and they can put some extra money in another field, they do. And this is a completely different, you know. I think the American is more business orientated, the European is more healthcare orientation.
Звезды мировой пластической хирургии с Ольгой Засеевой. Эстетика в разрезе. Джуми Масия, профессор, директор отделения микрохирургии и реконструкции молочной железы клиники Планас в Барселоне, один из идеологов мирового движения Breast Meeting.
What is your favorite surgery?
I have some of them. You know, for example, I like to do new things, and I like to do a little bit controversial things. For example, in the side of the aesthetic and the, for example, the implant reconstruction, what I really like is this prepectoral concept, because for many years everybody was subpectoral. And also I like this kind of hybrid surgery. It means only giving the volume that the patient need with the implant and then sculpting, you know, doing all the shaping with the fat. And this is what I really like. In the way for more the reconstructive, I like the difficult things. And for example, now I have something that I am waiting to publish, because sometimes the people steal the ideas. But with this lateral side, not the thoracodorsal, this here, there is some vessels, you can take a lot of volume of tissue. You can create a breast. Sometimes you need a little implant, or sometimes nothing. And this is extremely fast and easy. It's a little bit, you need to train how to find the vessels. But this extended anterior intercostal flap is one of my passions now. Everything that is new, I need to feel, you know, it's not risk, it's the challenge, you know, the challenge and the passion. You have a lot of stimulation is when you can be creative and then be excited and then try the thing and then believe in that you can do every day new things. This is the most important. When the people say, no, everything is done, we are doing like because for 20 years it works. When you are living under these comments, you're never excited. The excitement is, I want to try this, I want to see that. And of course that not always when you go to see new things, you find something special. But if you go looking for these new things and this excitement, at the end, every year you have like a new toy, no? This year is that, and it's like this, you know? It's very important to always listen to everybody. Sometimes, not only the big expert like Dennis Hammond or whatever, no. The comments from the audience, or the comments from one student, or one trainee came and I said, oh, I watched that, or do you think that could be possible? This is important, you know, listen everybody.
Эстетика в разрезе.
About this, patients today, what do they ask from the surgeon when they would like to do aesthetic procedure? What is their expectation? And is it any cases when you could say no to the patient?
I think so. You know, as a surgeon, you need to to know when you must say no, and that is a clear answer. You must say no when the patient cannot understand very well what you are going to do. Sometimes it is because you are not doing a good communication, or you don't know how to express. Sometimes it's because they cannot understand because they have not a real expectations.
In aesthetic
and also in the reconstruction, you know, the patient, they must understand what you are going to do, and you need to talk once, twice, or three times. But if you feel that the patient has no clear idea about the expectations, it's better don't do it. It happens to me a couple of months ago. One lady that somebody did a breast aesthetic surgery two or three times in another clinic, and I said, okay, this is going to take more than one surgery because we need to rebuild completely, you know, the shape, the volume, the correction of the scars, and I explained everything. But I could feel that the patient didn't catch what I was trying to do. But it will be perfect. It will be much better, but perfect. It cannot be because it's the four-time surgery. And then I explained once more. And I went to the room to make the marking, and the lady had no idea about that. And I said, sorry, but I cannot go to with you to theater. And the lady was in the clinic, he was in the bed, and he said, no, I cannot go. And the lady started crying, the mother started crying, but they said, I don't go now because it's for you, because I cannot go if you don't understand what are the limitations of the surgery and what you are going to spend, you know. And then he said, go home. Of course, you are not going to pay anything for that one day to be in the clinic, but take your time. And let's go to talk one more, or maybe twice, but you cannot go. And this is, for me, the indication for saying no, when the people, they don't have. For the patients, what is very important is don't be afraid to make questions. When the patients go to a doctor, even if it's full, the wall of titles and everything, don't be afraid to say, where did you make the training?
Yeah.
Well, I have 100 titles, but which is the good one? Yeah. Which is your qualifications? Because sometimes you go to a places and the people, they have titles and titles, but no one is good, because you can buy the titles in the market
easily.
and also, don't be afraid to make questions. Even what the people they offer, you read or you heard that something could be better. Could you explain me why it's not the best option and yours is the best option? And no one, no any good surgeon is going to be offended if they say, where is your title or your certificate as a plastic surgeon or as a breast surgeon? No, it's here. Or where did you learn? Okay, everybody, we are happy to share. I learned this in that country, it wasn't that. Or say, no, you are not right, even you read this in one of the website of the Mayo Clinic, because your case is different for that reason. I think that is the two things that patients and surgeons, we must have clear, you know, when to say no, or never miss the information or the chance to ask to your surgeon.
Звезды мировой пластической хирургии с Ольгой Засеевой. Эстетика в разрезе. Джуми Масия, профессор, директор отделения микрохирургии и реконструкции молочной железы клиники Планас в Барселоне, один из идеологов мирового движения Breast Meeting.
Okay, Gemma, three major advices for the young plastic surgeons how to be successful.
The thing is, the first one is to have dreams. You need to have dreams. You need to think in the future and that you want to be something special. It's good to be ambitious, you know. You said, okay, I want to be the best, I want to be like this. Second is believe in yourself, because not everybody can go to the best universities in the world, like Harvard or Yale or whatever. You know, people that is, you know, educated in a small university, in, I don't know, in Samara, can be a great surgeon, a great doctor, because it's true that you don't have the same opportunities, but if you work hard in the right way, you can achieve what you want. It's dreams, believe in yourself, and the most thing is be honest, be with you, your colleagues, and your patients. With this combination is dream, believe in yourself, and be honest and critic, you can achieve whatever you want.
And education.
Of course, you need education, but this is what the people also, the young people, they must ask for good education, and the senior people, we must work to provide this. And then the society and the world will improve a lot.
Thank you.
Звезды мировой пластической хирургии с Ольгой Засеевой. Эстетика в разрезе.